what is the strategy for success? The strategy for success in the preliminary examination is very, very simple. What simple is this? Plan for every area. Spread your efforts uniformly in all the areas. Areas means subjects. Spread your efforts. Pay attention to history as much as you pay attention to geography. Similarly, you have to pay attention to polity, current affairs, etc. Don't you ever give a stepmotherly attitude to any one of the subjects, because then it will show you stepfatherly attitude, that subject. You understand this? And use your mind and logic, allot time, proportional time for all the subjects. This is one strategy which you have to do. Secondly, calculated risk can be taken. I am not recommending that you should take, I am telling that you can take it. How, what calculated risk are we telling? Let us see, I have given sufficient time for history. 10 hours, let us say 10% of time I have given for history, let us say. Then history includes what? Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India. Now, when I say 10% of my preparation time I had given to history, that means that 10% of time I am not supposed to spend only in, let us say, ancient India or medieval India or modern India. You understand this first? In history also, based on the previous trend, we have to divide that 10% of time allotted for history. For example, we have observed a trend, slightly it varies. As far as history is concerned, if 10% of the time you are going to allot for history, then I am calculating that to be 100. If 100% of time you have taken for history, 50 to 55% of time to 60% you can give for modern India. Rest 40% you can give to ancient and medieval India. You understand this? When I say modern India, 50 to 60% of your time, modern India means which part of modern India? That also is there, no? Now, we have modern India starting from 1707 to, of course, now the questions have been asked in post-independence also, up to 1964. Which part? Now, we have to focus more attention to the part which is the last part. Modern India, three parts. First, decline and disintegration of the Mughal, entry of the British, consolidation of the British, then of course our national movement, which includes the social religious reform movements also. So the first part is decline and disintegration and entry of the British. Second part is consolidation of the British, which includes all other measures, institutions. Then the third part roughly starts around 1857 and later, maybe including social religious reform movement, Indian National Congress and all other things. And here in this 50% of time, 60% of time which I have allotted for history, I am going to give in that 50% has to be allotted for the last part. You understand this first? Sir, calculated risk means what? No, I will tell you. Calculated risk means not eliminating the whole of ancient India in history or medieval India or part one of modern India which I have spoken. Calculated risk means some area, let us say, just to give an example, calculated risk, maybe in modern India, if I see, let us say the acts in the modern India, acts, all other acts, no, starting from the regulating acts, which in the act, X, Y, Z, all acts are there. For some people, it is constantly confusing. How much ever you read, it is confusing. First, you make an attempt to read. And if it is confusing, maybe that among all the acts, 2-3 acts only you can do properly. Or in all the acts, every act 2-3 points you can do. Not more than that. For example, 1773 Act, 2 points. Pits in the Act, just these 2 points I know that this is the provisions of the Pits in the Act. That's it. I do not know any other points about this Act. 1919 Act, 1935 Acts, etc. So, calculated risk means this. Calculated risk doesn't mean that you are closing your eye to one part of a subject. No, this is going to be highly costly. Okay. And also understand the simple logic in UPSC. No candidate, I am giving an open statement without any ifs, buts, etc. No candidate in UPSC in the past history or the present times or the future is going to complete the total syllabus and is going to attempt the examination. Understand this truth first. So that means every one of the candidates is preparing for the examination, including you. They are taking a choice decisions in spending more time in a particular part, less time in a particular part of the subject. And that decides your success. Not how much time you allotted. What is a failure strategy? 10% of the time allotted for GS, I am allotting for history. That 10% of time, let us say, if I am strong in modern India, only I am investing in modern India. Wrong. Because to master modern India, even the 10% of time is not sufficient. To average modern India, possible. Average study of ancient medieval India, possible. And I am telling you, the average study in all the subjects is going to help you to sail through the preliminary very easily. Just go through this ancient India, if for example, just know the chronology. Dates, some books here and there, Buddhist councils, this and that. And normally, I have seen questions are very simple. And I am ensuring that you should not miss a simple question, whether it is an area which you are read or an area which you are not read. In all areas, no simple question should be left. This is the strategy for success I am speaking. The strategy for success in the preliminary is that you do all the questions irrespective of any area which is easy. Sir, one question, simple question. I have completely closed my eye to ancient India, sir. But the question was about the third Buddhist council and the ruler. You understand? The question was about the third Buddhist council. Sir, the problem is, I have closed my eye to the whole of ancient India. So you did not attempt the question. But I am telling you, it is the easiest of all questions. 250 BC, Ashoka. So just spend some time in an area and just basic facts can be known. And the successful candidate knows all the basic facts. And he knows something additional also. But the problem with most of the candidates who fail is that they spend most of the time in trying to know the additional facts and they do not pay attention to learning the basic facts. That's why when you discuss with some of the aspirants, they say, sir, I know this, I know that, but do you know the third Buddhist council? He says, sir, ancient India I have not studied. You understand? No, this is a route to failure. And the route to success, basic facts in every area has to be studied. Even an area if you do not know, for example, science. Let us say, I am a science student, by the way. You don't think I am taking myself as an example. I am a science student and I did post-graduation in history and my option was history and geography. I love polity and economy. You people understand? This is the attitude and approach of UPSC aspirant. It should be. There should be no subject wherein which you say this is an untouchable subject. No. Of course, you might not like, but some basic relation has to be established with the subject. Let us take, for example, science. Even if you do not like science, even if you are not a student of science also, basics science you must know. Not only for UPSC examination, for every competitive examination, there are some basics which is asked, which would not exceed more than 30 pages, if you ask me. 30 pages, that's it. You understand? That you read. If you do not, means like history also. Understood. 30 pages for ancient, 30 pages for medieval, and 40-50 pages for modern. Without which you should not go to any examination, knowing this. And those basic datas we have given you already, I am thinking in the form of book, in the form of material. I have given additional material also in order to satisfy those people who wanted that extra mark, no, without bothering about the basic mark. For them, I have given that additional material also. But please, in every area, know these basics, whether it is a polity also. No, you may be knowing a lot of provisions. Fundamental rights people do not know when they go to write the preliminary examination, the articles they do not know. You understand what are the provisions in which this is coming. So first be thorough with the basics. This will guarantee success. All the candidates who are cleared, please understand this very, very carefully. You can get a service in UPSC. You can become, let us say, you can get an IAS. Possible, that is, of course, it requires a lot of efforts. But that candidate who got a service this year, nobody can guarantee that next preliminary is going to clear. Do you know this fact? I have students who have written, who have got a service already. They got around 300, 400 rank. Now they wanted to be in the topper, so next year they wrote, but they did not clear even the preliminary because preliminary is highly risky. Mains consistency can be maintained in the mains. Entry mark, of course, consistency can be maintained, but the preliminary is highly risky. And if you want to evade this risk, do these things which I am telling you. And I have seen people who consistently clear preliminary. Mains, of course, they are not clearing. How? Sir, these basics, they know the basics very strong. All the basics, when you say, sir, they have known it. So I am telling, even that preliminary which cannot be predicted, can be predicted, can, means results can be harvested by doing those basic work. You understand? So devise your time meticulously. It's never late, still we have a lot of time. How much time are we left with still? Almost? 70 plus days, no? Sufficient. Every minute you have to use. How? We have known, no? Sometimes people, they are, means some madness had entered into them. They constantly think about something, and we have seen people like this wandering. Now this 70 days you have to be like this. Morning you get up, you have to think about the examination. Preliminary, yeah, this subject, that subject. Afternoon, after your food. Always, this is called focus, I am telling. Don't lose the focus. Don't deviate yourself from UPSC. I am telling, if you want to really clear. Otherwise, if you come here for spending your time, having good friendship, then it's all different. If you want to clear this examination, don't you ever deviate. Keep that focus. From the time you get up from the morning, not necessarily you have to open your book and study, but think that you are here for clearing the examination. Not necessarily you have to open your book, but your mind constantly has to say that I am here to clear this examination. Understand? That is what I am calling it is focus. If you are focused for the next 78 days or whatever it is, definitely you can clear this examination. Preliminary, definitely you can clear.